Hi, and welcome back to This Bytes For You. So a lot of you have been asking me, hey Iggy, how do I move my Windows from one drive to another drive? Or how do I clone one drive to another drive? So you're trying to get rid of your old clunky, slow mechanical drive, move over to an SSD or an M.2 SSD, or from an SSD over to an M.2 SSD, or any which way, even from one of these guys to another one of these guys. So don't worry, I've got the perfect solution for you in this video. What makes it even better? It's totally free. So a while ago, I made a video on cloning using a cloner, but it's gonna cost you like 20 bucks. And also it doesn't always work right. If you're going from a larger drive to a smaller drive, it won't work at all. If you're going from a smaller drive to a larger drive, that will work, and it only works with these two. It doesn't work with an M.2. Again, I got you covered, so come over here real quick. Let's get started, and please make sure to watch to the very end. If you miss a step, you could potentially lose all your data. And while you're at it, don't forget to click like and subscribe. It helps me out a ton. That way, I know that I can keep bringing you videos like this and bigger and better videos. But anyway, let's get started. So the very first thing you're going to want to do is turn off your computer so that you can install your SSD or your M.2 SSD. All right, so with your machine off, we're going to go ahead and grab the SATA power cable. Just plug this guy in. And the SATA data cable. Now, the power cable comes with a power supply, and the data cable comes with the motherboard, or you can buy it separately. I'll have links to everything in the description below. So now with the SSD installed, we're just gonna go ahead, turn on the computer, and go into the BIOS real quick. Okay, now in the BIOS, we'll just go over to boot, and we want to verify that the M.2 drive that we have in there already, or whatever drive we have in there already, is already set up as the Windows boot manager, and we don't have that other drive trying to take that spot. So now that we're verified, just go ahead, save and exit. Okay, so once we're in Windows, the first thing you're going to want to do if this is a brand new drive is right click on the start button, go to disk management, find your brand new disk. You'll know which one it is because it says unallocated. Then if it says offline here, just right click on here and click online. Okay, so then after you bring it online, you right click over here, new simple volume, next, whatever capacity you want it to have, or lower if you want to partition it, but for now, we'll use the entire drive. Next, assign it the drive letter D, it doesn't matter at this point. New volume, smaller drives take less time, this will take 5 seconds, maybe 10. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and close out of here. So now we're going to go ahead and open up a browser and we'll go to aomeitech.com. Don't worry, I have the link and everything down below. Then we'll go to download and then here we'll just download this. I've already installed it. Don't worry, this is not a sponsored video. This is free for the clone purposes that we want to use it for. There is paid versions and tiers, but for cloning, this will work just fine. If you like the software, of course, go ahead and buy it, but this will work for free. Okay, so I've already downloaded and installed it, so I'll just close that of here. And we'll come back to that in a second. And then after we've done activating the partition and downloading and installing it, we'll go ahead and open up Aomei Backupper Standard. I didn't name the software. So then we'll go over here, click clone. And then we'll have two options, but we want to focus on disk clone here. Okay, so here we'll click on the source disk, which is a 1.82 terabyte drive, and click next. And then we'll select the source disk, which is only a 500 gig drive, so 465 gigs. Now, if we come over here to File Explorer and click on this PC, you'll notice that even though this is a 2 terabyte drive, if we right click on it and go to properties, there's only 372 gigs used on it, which would fit perfectly fine in this drive. It makes sense that you can only put, let's say, 464 gigs on this drive that'll allow you to put 465 gigs because you can fit all that. It doesn't need to shrink it. It just fits. Now, if you had a 600 gig or a 2 terabyte drive with 600 gigs on it, you can't move that over. So if you want to make this work, you're going to have to delete some files. Okay, so we can close out of here. And now that we've selected the destination disk, the blank disk, we'll click next. This is just letting you know, hey, this is going to go ahead and wipe anything on that destination, but it's a blank disk. So click okay. And just reiterating what's going to happen, this 1.82 terabyte drive is going to clone into this 465 gig drive. If it doesn't fit, it'll tell you here and click start clone. Now, depending on how much data you have on the drive is going to depend how long this process will take. If you only have 50 gigs, it'll take under 2 minutes. A 300 whatever gig drive into that, it's going to take about 10 minutes or so. Don't worry, I'll fast forward. All right, now that all this pops up, we know that everything works. So if we come into this PC, now you can see that they're going to have the same amount of data. Right click on the D drive, 312 gigs. Right click on the C drive properties, 372 gigs. That is probably going to be due to the virtual paging memory file, but we're good. So we'll go ahead and close this. Congratulations, the clone task has been completed successfully. Okay, so now make sure to click finish here and then we can close it. So then we'll go ahead back into file manager and just notice that the C drive is that 2 terabyte drive and the D drive is that 500 gig drive. So now what we're going to go ahead and do is go ahead and restart and put that 500 gig as the main drive. Okay, so now back in the BIOS, we'll go back over to boot and under option number one, we'll see we're still on the sovereign drive, but we'll go ahead and switch over to the SATA SSD. Press enter there, F10 to save and exit, and okay. Okay, so now that we're back in Windows, we'll go into File Explorer, this PC, and you'll notice now the 500 gig has the C drive, and the D drive is the 2 terabyte drive. So easy enough, right? I've shown you how to clone a larger drive into a smaller drive, but it's not as easy cloning a smaller drive into a larger drive. I mean, literally, it is as easy, but there's a few more steps, and I'm gonna show you how right now. Okay, so closing out of here, open up your browser again, and this time we're going to go ahead and download, also from Aomei, the Aomei Partition Assistant. I'll go ahead and put that link down in the description below. I've already downloaded it and installed it, so opening it up. So now what I'm going to go ahead and do, because I'm so certain everything worked fine, I'm just going to select that 2 terabyte partition right here. You'll see that 1.82 terabyte. Just make sure you have the right drive. Right click on that and click delete all partitions. Select delete all partitions and click OK. So now if we close here, we'll select yes and proceed. Yes, I want to start. Congratulations, all operations have been completed successfully. Okay, so if we come back into File Explorer, this PC, now we'll see, hey, wait a minute, the other drive is gone. That's okay. Right click on your start button, disk management, and you'll notice it right over here, shows online, so we don't need to right click and click online. We'll just right click on the unallocated space, new simple volume, next. And we'll just go through all this real quick since we've already done it. This is a faster drive, so it takes less time. And we'll close out of here. Now we'll see our new old empty drive. Okay, so now we'll just close out of there. Come back into Aomei Backupper. Then we go under clone, like we did before, disk clone. Select the source disk, which is now the 500 gig. Click next. And destination disk. And then we click next as well. Warning, all that stuff, okay. This is just reiterating what's gonna happen. We're moving that 500 gig, we're copying it, disk zero, into the 2 terabyte drive, disk one, start clone. Now, the beginning process is super simple. You basically don't have to click on it, or think about it, sorry. But you're going to see what happens when we boot back into Windows. Now, on the larger drive that just got the smaller drive copied into it. All right, and just like we did before, click on this PC, and then you'll see that. Now, this can be a little scary. You'll notice whichever the 2 terabyte drive is, it's now a 500 gig drive. And don't worry, I'm gonna show you how to get past that. So we'll close out of here. Important, click finish. Okay, and then we can close out of here. So if we come back over here into disk management, you'll notice that the disk zero, 97 megs for the UEFI bootloader, the boot manager. This is all your data. And 970 megs for the recovery partition. Now coming to disk one, we'll see the same 97 megs for the EFI boot manager, the same 464 gigs for data, 970 megs for the recovery partition, but then we have 1.397.26 unallocated space. Now you don't want to do that because that'll make a drive E. So what you want to do is, like I showed you before, and actually let's go ahead and do that in the live environment. So let's go ahead, reboot back into the BIOS. Okay, and when we're in the BIOS, we'll go over to boot. And it looks like it took the Sabrent again. Remember, we originally selected this guy. So we just copied it back to the Sabrent. F10 to save and exit. Okay, so now that we're back in Windows, right click on the start button, disk management. And I just want to verify that the C drive, yep, is the 2 terabyte drive again. We'll notice the 500 gig went to the D drive. So to fix this issue that they're both 500 gigs now, we'll open the partition assistant. Okay, and then we'll scroll down. Let's resize this a little bit. So down here we can see everything. So we'll right click on that 500 gig partition from the 2 terabyte drive. Right click on that. We'll do merge partitions. Okay, then you don't want to select any of these. I don't think you can. No, you can't. Okay, so we'll have the C drive already selected because that's the one we want to merge out or expand from. And then we'll click the unallocated side. Click OK. Then click apply up here. This is just letting you know what it's going to do. And it will require a reboot. Proceed. Restart into Windows PE mode, pre-installation environment mode. Okay. Okay, then we're gonna see a screen like this pop up. It's going to be doing its work on the back end. There is no interaction you need to provide. This takes about 30 seconds, if that. All right, so that was quick. All operations have been finished successfully. Now we click restart now. Your computer will automatically restart in 20 seconds. Now, restart now will take a little bit longer than usual. Don't manually restart it. It'll do its own thing. Okay, so now that we're back in Windows yet again, open up Explorer, File Explorer, this PC, and now you can breathe easy. you have your 2 terabyte drive back. And then since this is a clone of this, we can just go back into Aomei Partition Assistant. Select that 500 gig drive. Delete partition. Delete partition quickly. Unallocated. And then, yes, we forgot to apply it again. Now this will take you back into Windows PE mode. Then come back over here. This PC, oh no, it's missing. Like we did before, right click on the start button, disk management, and it looks like it left a little behind. So what we're going to need to do in this one, that unfortunately will take a while. Okay, so then we'll right click again on this guy. Then we'll do a delete all partitions. Delete all partitions or delete all partitions, wipe all data on drive. Fill sectors with 0, safe and quick. We can select the rest, but they do require pro licenses. So we'll keep this one. Click OK. Then click apply up here. Yes and yes. Then you can see down here where it's starting to wipe out all the data over here. Now, mind you, there is different ways to do it, especially in disk part, but disk part is very risky, especially if you don't know what you're doing. All right, so while that's doing its thing, there are other ways to clear that partition, quicker ways to do it, but I just wanted to show you how to do it from within the tool. It does a great job. The clearing part does take a little while. I don't want you to sit through that, but it does everything else pretty quick. So I've covered how to go from a larger capacity disk to a smaller capacity disk, and then also how to go from a smaller capacity disk to a larger capacity disk, and then free up all that space so that you don't have 500 gigs on your 2 terabyte drive and you can't access the rest. That's ridiculous. So hopefully I've helped you guys. If you're still stuck on a mechanical drive, move over quick to an M.2. And if your motherboard doesn't support M.2, get a regular SATA SSD. The performance difference is amazing. Alone starting into Windows, it'll take anywhere from 4 seconds to 12 seconds. But regardless of that, or should I say, it'll take from 12 or 30 seconds down to 4 or 12 seconds. But anyway, aside from all that, I really do hope this video has helped you. If it's helped you, make sure again to like and subscribe. Share the video out with your friends. Help them help, you know, as well, because, you know, we've been in your shoes. I've been in those shoes that I didn't know what I was doing. So I wanted to share that knowledge with you guys, but let me know what you think down in the comments below. Everything I've gone over hardware-wise is down in the description as well, and as well as my system specs if you guys were interested. Again, any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou. See you guys.